Hi there, this is Keyslinger 5. Most of you probably know me as a music video maker, not a help video maker. But I was watching some writing advice videos and realized that there's not many on music video advice, at least I'm not running into them. So I have taken it upon myself to give you guys some tips and tricks for making music videos. Couple quick businessy-esque notes before we get started here. It first being that I can only give music video advice based off of my experience. Now, it's not that I've solely done Kingdom Hearts music videos. I have done music videos to other media than Kingdom Hearts, but the main bulk of my stuff has been Kingdom Hearts. Therefore, most of my examples will probably include Kingdom Hearts scenes, and this is just because it's what I have available. Obviously, these tips will apply to any media that you use. Another note is for Kingdom Hearts fans, spoiler warnings. My media includes footage from every Kingdom Hearts game to date, including the Remind and Kingdom Hearts 3. So, spoiler warnings. Also, I'm here to give you advice about the actual art of making a music video, so I'm not going to be giving you tips on equipment to get. I assume you have your equipment, your media, the things you need to make a music video. This is tips for making a music video, not for what to use to make music videos. Finally, I won't always use an exact excerpt from one of my videos, but when I use a song, it'll be a song that I have posted a video on YouTube too. So, I will be also trying to include the links to my videos, to the songs, so that if you want to see what I did, you can go check that out. And I hope you guys enjoy the tips I give you, might help you with your own music videos, and might help you appreciate music videos you watch a bit more too. So, fun for all. Let's go. First tip is you have to choose the right song for the character. Sure, you could just pick a song that you like and just put whatever character to it, but it's not going to be as effective. I mean, if you just did this, you could end up with something like this.
When did I become the one who's always chasing your heart? Now I turn around and find I am lost in the woods. North is south, right is left, when you're gone.
Now, it looks okay, but does that really make any sense? Instead, I chose this path.
When did I become the one who's always chasing your heart? Now I turn around and find I am lost in the woods. North is south, right is left, when you're gone.
Because I chose the right characters to match the song, the video itself is a lot more effective and evokes more emotion than if we did Lost in the Woods to Organization 13, which, albeit, would be sort of funny. But I'm not looking for funny in that video, I'm looking to tug at your heartstrings. Number two, line up both the lyrics and the music. Now, obviously, if you're doing an instrumental, there are no lyrics and you're lining up solely with the music. Make sure you listen to the music even if you have lyrics. It'll make the video a lot more impactful if you do this. For example, that's not nearly as effective as if I had lined it up like this. In this way, the moment in the music is more impactful than if I had just let it be just thrown in wherever. Now, people don't always notice when you do this, but they certainly notice when you don't. One thing to keep in mind is you're not just looking for harsh beats. Just because you don't hear the drums banging away or cymbal crashes does not mean that there's nothing to line up with. In quieter songs, you may have to look at other instrumentation. Piano, strings, whatever. Here's an example of not lining up with harsh drum beats, just so you can kind of get a feel.
It's the second glance that ties your hands as darkness pulls the strings. Be careful, little feet, where you go.
Number 3. Watch out for the blip. Now, the blip is not, I don't think, at least a technical term used in music videos. I have determined that it's a technical term that I use for my music videos, and so I have to outline, what is a blip? Well, here's an example of a blip in action. Whoa, wait a second. What was that in there? Is that... that's Xehanort sneaking in there. Well, we don't want that. And as you can probably tell from the video, it catches the eye. You may not have been able to tell what it was, but your eyes caught that it was something. And that was the blip. The blip, as you saw, is when you have a scene and you move it over just a little, too far, and you get to the next camera angle change. Sometimes they're a little harder to sleuth out, especially if it's a smoother transition, but the eye will catch it. And the problem with the blips is they throw your mind for a loop, and therefore evict your audience from the video. And the point of the music video is to draw the audience into your music video. So, therefore, you don't want blips. Sometimes this can prove hard, because maybe your scene is just like one frame short of reaching the next spot and extending the correct amount. So, I'll probably do a future video on some tips and tricks for working around the blip, but trust me when I say that it is better to have your next scene start a little earlier than to have that blip. It's a little less noticeable. It's the lesser of the two evils. So keep an eye out for those blips, because I have seen them in official media before, as in movie menus. It's bad. Just check and double check. Keep your eye on those blips. They're tricky. Number 4. Do not use repeat scenes. I cannot tell you how often I have seen a music video where, and I don't make a hobby of watching others' music videos. I have my own reasons for that if you really want. I will explain in a future video if you guys ask. So, watch this short excerpt I threw together, and, well, you can see for yourself. I'm unsure if you were able to completely notice or not, but within those few scenes, I used two scenes twice. And now, it's not always a bad thing. This is more of a me personally finding this to be sloppy. Because you have a whole bunch, assumedly, of media to draw from. And just because this one scene matches both lines, you use it more than once. And it's like, why? When you, with a little bit of searching, you could find something unrelated and do something new and fresh.
Another note about using the same scenes in multiple spots is oftentimes there's one spot where it's more effective than the other spot. So obviously you want to go with that one. And most of the time, you can find another shot that will line up with the lyric you are looking for.
Now, if it's the same scene from, say, a different camera angle, it looks totally different. As long as the camera angle is different, you can use the same line over and over. But if it's the exact same word-for-word scene, you can do better. There's other stuff out there, most likely. And if there's nothing else, then you might want to rethink doing a music video to the character you have chosen, because there may or may not actually be enough shots to do a music video to the character you want to do the music video to. And that's sad. That's not doing the character any favors. More on choosing the correct character and such in a later video on more pro tips. And number 5, let the video sit. Oftentimes, when you just finish a video, you think it's great. You've just finished this. You leave, go to bed, have a full day of work or school or whatever you do all day, come back and watch it, and it's suddenly horrible. Okay, maybe not horrible, but at least it's a, I thought this was good, and maybe it's not. Now, if you had just posted that immediately after you finished it, then you would have posted a video that you eventually end up thinking is lackluster. And I'll admit that has happened a couple times with a couple of my videos, but it hasn't been a bad case of that yet. I had a video just the other day that I finished it and thought it was great. I came back a couple days later and watched it and went, oh no, this is not ready for prime time yet. I have to rework that video. No, I am not giving you spoilers of the song that I did to, or the characters that are in it, because I will be redoing that video. It just was not quite what I wanted from the song in the video. So, let your videos lie. Normally it's best to let it sit overnight at least. Preferably more, or if you like did it in the morning, then were out all day and came back and watched it in the evening, that's sometimes enough time. But I'd suggest giving it 24 hours before you post, just personally. Just so you are sure that what you are putting out is your best work. And frankly, that's what we want. We want to do the best we can. That's all the tips I have for you guys for today. Now, those of you who are longtime subscribers or know my channel at all know that this is not my usual fare. Normally, I just make and post music videos. I've decided to try something different, obviously. This is going to be a series, hopefully. It'll become a series. Assuming all goes well, this is the beginning of a series of videos on music video tips, sharing with you guys the knowledge that I have amassed over my years of making music videos. I will try to release them on Fridays. It may not be every Friday or even every other Friday, but it will be Fridays. If one of these releases, it will be on Friday. I'm going to try to do it every week, but I expect that that will not happen at times. I'll also try to let you guys know if I know I'm coming up on a busy week, so you know not to expect it. And I guess this will be kind of the videos where I give you guys any businessy stuff. I'll try to limit that for the end for any longtime subscribers. By the by, love you guys. I never expected to have more than like 5 subscribers, and like 3 of them being people I know in real life. So I very much appreciate that I have 35 subscribers right now. I know it doesn't sound like a lot, and I know it's not a lot, but I appreciate you guys. You may be few, but guess you know quality when you see it. Give yourselves a high five or a fist bump from me or however you want your, yeah, your awesome thing today. And keep an eye out for more music videos. There will be no schedule for normal music videos, just for these info video things of awesomeness. And if you're not a subscriber and have never seen any of my music videos before, you've seen a sample of what I do, so what are you waiting for? Go check them out if you enjoy Kingdom Hearts. If you don't and you're just here for the advice, go watch them anyway and analyze them. Tell me what things you like and didn't like. Say something in the comments below. I don't care. You guys can talk to me. I'll talk back. I always read your comments. I may not always understand your comments, but I will do my best. Added note to that, if there's something you would like me to hit upon in these videos or expand upon in these videos in the future, go ahead and shoot a comment in the comments below. Let me know what you want to hear. With that, enjoy the rest of your day, and I'll see you guys soon. Bye!